Hi, everybody. I'm Jones.
And I'm Man. And we're Jones and Man. And today, we're going to be jonesing over this Jack Daniel's Gentleman Jack. Jones, I'm not a big whiskey drinker, so a plain whiskey drinker.
Right.
So we kind of started this off with a little bit of the entry level Black Jack Daniels, a little bit of the honey, a couple other things just to kind of open my palate as it relates to whiskey.
The typical Jack that you get at a bar if you ask for a whiskey on,
for sure.
You know, if you go to the bar and say, hey, let me get a whiskey on the rocks or just a double shot of whiskey, you don't realize it, but Jack Daniels is like the McDonald's of the whiskey brand, especially Tennessee whiskey. People think of whiskey, that's exactly what they think of, is that Jack Daniels.
Yeah. So we're going to follow same house rules as always. We'll start off neat with a nice little shot. We'll finish it up with, on the rocks, we've got some cool little whiskey balls in these holiday Gentleman Jack glasses.
Right.
And then from there, we'll give our reviews and tell me what you think. So before I bust this one open, what can you tell us about that Gentleman Jack? How's it different from the Jack Daniels that we started with?
Well, like I said before, this is the mid-grade of the Jack Daniels brand. So you have the entry level that you get at the bar when you ask for a typical whiskey.
Right.
Then you have this brand, which is
my favorite sound.
That's right.
My favorite.
This is my second favorite sound. And then you have this one, which is designed or targeted more toward bourbon drinkers or entry-level whiskey drinkers. So whereas you only send the single barrel through the cold charcoals once, just like you would the entry-level Jack, where this is sent through the charcoals twice. So it takes some of that oaky taste out of it and mellows it out, makes it a little bit smoother. Less of the what you always normally say, the ash taste.
Ashtray kind of taste,
yeah.
So that's that double mellow part.
Yeah, that's what the double mellow means.
Gotcha. All right, so it smells pretty good. We'll take a good kind of whiff over here.
And you can tell that, you know, it has a nice scent smell to it.
Yeah, you know, now this smells a lot softer than the regular Jack.
Yeah, that
you know,
Jack
I hope it tastes accordingly.
Yeah.
So, clink them and drink them?
Clink them and drink them.
Oh yeah. Now, you know, I'm not a big plain whiskey fan, but that's way better than the regular Black Jack Daniels.
Oh yeah.
You get a little burn.
Yeah, you still get the burn that you normally like with a shot of whiskey.
Yeah.
Let you know that you actually drank something.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, but that's definitely a lot better.
It's that bad word for any kind of, I guess, alcohol, is smooth.
Smooth, yeah.
It's semi-smooth because you still get that burn to the back of your palate, but you get to taste what it actually tastes like. So let's see if we put it on the rocks, if it's going to kind of calm it down a little bit and make it easier for us to drink, especially somebody that's not a big whiskey drinker.
And I like, you know, some flavored whiskey, a couple little things in there, but just regular straight out the bottle whiskey, neat. Not normally on my bar list, but you know, I can get into it.
At one time, you know, I tried this a long time ago and it was really great, and I just haven't had it in a long time. So now having it again, it's like, okay,
yeah, and bringing it back around.
It's bringing it back around. Like, man, this is really good. And it, like I said, it's a medium, you know, medium cost. This is roughly about $35 a bottle. Not too bad. It's your typical premium mid-grade whiskey.
And during the holidays, you can get two cool glasses to go with it? Yep, a one.
Two cool glasses.
Two cool glasses.
And the other, I also saw another gift set that had some cool coasters.
Yeah. Holiday season is the best time for going to the ABC store. Those gift sets, I buy stuff that I don't even normally drink. And that's how we fell in love with Zaya,
that other rum,
which hopefully we'll review later through a gift set. So, you ready? Let's clink them and drink them. Oh, yeah. See, that, now that takes that takes all the bite out. You still get...
That's where it is right there.
The bite and the burn. I mean, that's really good.
You get a bite and a burn, but it's like a mellow bite and a burn.
Yeah. It's a little spicy.
Yeah.
You know, I don't. It's kind of peppery. I guess that would be the right word. I don't really get the same oaky barrel flavor that you get with like some scotches
and
some
of the ashtray.
Some of the rums that I like, especially on the rocks, it really tones it down a lot.
On the rocks, tones it down. And what I've learned with this particular Jack Daniels is if you mix it with ginger ale, oh my god, that is like the best.
Yeah, that was gonna be my next question. So what would you mix it with?
I'll mix it with obviously you can mix it with Coke.
Okay. Yep.
But you know, I don't know what it is about the ginger ale and that ginger taste that brings that peppery and spicy taste and the caramel notes out. Man, it tastes wonderful with ginger ale. Okay. I always call it Jack and Ginger.
All right, so you know, let's give the people what they've been waiting for. So, would you say that this is in your category of favorites, or is it a fail, a flop?
For me, this is definitely a keeper, maybe a favorite.
Okay.
It's definitely one that if I can't find one of my regular, more hard to find whiskeys or bourbons, it's a definite go-to.
Okay.
Or if I was going to have a house party instead of having some of my higher end, harder to find whiskeys, this is one I would have on my shelf because it gives you a good taste, a lot of good flavors, but it doesn't overpower the palate and it's not very difficult to drink.
Yeah, for sure.
It should be very easy to mix.
Yeah, for sure. I would definitely say in the whiskey realm, straight whiskey, if I was comparing regular Jack to Gentleman Jack, this would be my favorite for sure. I don't know if I would necessarily go out to the bar and order a Gentleman Jack. Maybe with Coke, but with Coke, I might as well order the regular Jack Daniels because I imagine it would probably be about the same. I'd love to kind of... You know, put some Coke in both and kind of give it a try, but not necessarily a favorite. Yeah, not necessarily a favorite for me, but on the rocks, definitely a major improvement.
Yeah,
major improvement.
Well, that's what I always tell people about. Try. That's why the house rules are what they are. Try it as a shot so you can actually get a taste of what the alcohol tastes like.
For sure.
And then with definitely a whiskey or a bourbon, you add a little bit of water to it. And it calms it down, and you get to taste more of the flavors with less of the burn. So that's why the house rules kind of are what the house rules are. You know, you take the shot for the taste, then you get the ice or the rocks to kind of tighten it up.
Yeah.
Then you can tell if you want it neat or if you definitely need some something to calm it down.
For sure. So there you have it, folks. We got one semi-favorite. One, I definitely will put this in your ear. I've seen it tons of times. So definitely send it as a favorite. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Be sure to subscribe. Comment if you like it. Comment if you don't like it. Comment. And we'll see you next time. This has been an episode of Jones and Man.